biology class. So today we are looking at a grade 10 topic on nutrition. So we are going to look at plant nutrition, but before that we will generally define what nutrition is and the modes of nutrition. So now let's start. What is nutrition? Nutrition is the process by which living organisms get nutrients and utilize them in their bodies. Or we can say it's the process by which living organisms obtain food, and this food is utilized in their bodies to enable them to perform different functions such as reproduction, movement, all those activities. Now, you will discover that these living organisms, they have different ways in which they feed or in which they find food. So these are referred to as modes or types of nutrition. So the mode of nutrition differ depending on the living organism. Like the way plants feed is not the same way as us human beings feed. So that's why we are saying that it depends with the living organism. And then we are also referring to nutrition as a process by which living organisms get their food. It's only things that live that feed. So that's what we are emphasizing, to say living organisms obtain their food, or ways in which living organisms obtain their food. So there are two ways, or there are two modes. That is autotrophic, which can also be referred to as autotrophism, and then also the second one, heterotrophic or heterotrophism. Now, we need to look at these terms. What do they mean? Or rather, how do these living organisms feed? Very good. Let's go to heterotrophic. So these words can be interchanged. They just mean one and the same thing. So heterotrophism is when living organisms take in, as in eating, already made complex materials or food, such as carbohydrates, proteins, fats. Now, where do they get this food from? They obtain this food from the bodies of plants and animals. For example, as a human being, you get or obtain food from plants, such as a cabbage, such as grape, or you can kill a goat. So that's what we are saying, that we obtain already made food. So the plants have already manufactured the food, and also we are going to get just the animal and slaughter it and kill it. So we have not made anything. We are getting what has already been made. Very good. I hope we are together here. Yeah? So now, what do we call these living organisms that eat food that has already been made? These are referred to as heterotrophs. So there is a difference between heterotrophs and heterotrophism. Heterotrophism is a way of obtaining food. But heterotrophs, these are living organisms which take in complex food materials. So we, like human beings, we take food that has already been made by plants. Very good. We move on. The second category is autotrophism or autotrophic. So the same like heterotrophism, even this one is a way or a mode of feeding. So living organisms manufacture complex food materials from simple substances. Or we can say that living organisms make their own food. Now, the living organisms that normally make their own food are plants. Then we also have some bacteria. We also have a type of algae that makes their own food. So remember, for autotrophism, the living organisms, they manufacture their own food. Very good. Now, what do we call these living organisms that make their own food? We refer to them as autotrophs. So these are living organisms which manufacture their own food. Types of autotrophic nutrition. Remember, we said that autotrophic, these are living organisms that make their own food. So we have one photosynthesis. So living organisms manufacture food using light as a source of energy. Now, they don't just use light. There is need for the presence of chlorophyll, and they use simple substances or raw materials such as water and carbon dioxide. Very good. So this photosynthesis usually occurs in green plants and photosynthetic bacteria. Number two, chemosynthesis. So this is where living organisms obtain energy to manufacture food from chemical reactions in their bodies. And this usually occurs in chemosynthetic bacteria. Super. Now let's look at nutrition in plants. Plants are autotrophic. That is, they make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. Now, photosynthesis involves the manufacturing of complex food materials from simple substances such as carbon dioxide and water using energy from the sun. So this is where now the plants, they use chlorophyll that is found in the leaves to capture the sunlight. When it captures the sunlight, the carbon dioxide is going to react with the water, and then food is going to be made, or simple sugars, which is referred to as glucose, will be formed. You will discover that the process of photosynthesis is a long process. We are going to talk about that. But for now, let's concentrate on the word equation and chemical equation of photosynthesis. So the word equation for photosynthesis is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of light and chlorophyll, which gives glucose and gives out a byproduct known as oxygen gas. Now, in the exam, they can also ask you to write the chemical formula for photosynthesis. So let us try and see if we can actually write the chemical formula for photosynthesis. We start carbon dioxide. What's the chemical formula of carbon dioxide? You must be right. CO2. CO2. Very good. Then for water, it's H2O. H2O. Then we have the light and the chlorophyll there. Glucose. I think in the very first term of grade 10, you learned about carbohydrates, and we say that for simple sugars, the chemical formula is C6H12O6. C6H12O6. Then what's the chemical formula for oxygen gas? You were right. O2. Very good. So this is the chemical equation for photosynthesis. But are we done? No, not as yet. Why? Chemistry requires us that we need to balance up whatever is this side, the numbers that are this side of the atoms should be equal to the ones that are this side. So we start with carbon. Carbon here is only one. We count it as one. Eh? This side, it is six, so it's not balanced. So let us try to put a six here in front. So carbon is six here, and carbon is six. We have balanced that. Very good. Let's look at oxygen. Since we added this six, so this oxygen is 2 times 6, which is 12, this side. And this other one, 1. So this will be 13. Let's check the other side. Oxygen, this side is 2. This side is 6. So this is 6 plus 2, which is 8. And the other side is 13. So there is no balance. Let's try to put a 6 here. 2 times 6 will be 12. Then we have this 6, which will be 18. So still on this side, it's not balanced. We have to add something. So let's put a 6 here. This oxygen will be 6. And then this side, 2, 6, 6 times 2 will be 12. plus this one 18. So we have balanced up the oxygen. Let's try and see the hydrogen. 2 times 6 is 12. And this side it is 12. So the chemical equation is now balanced. So this is how you write the full chemical equation for photosynthesis. The process of photosynthesis involves many chemical reactions. We have already said that the important raw materials needed are carbon dioxide and water. So the chemical reactions are divided into two. There's what we call the light stage and the dark stage. So we start with the light stage. It can also be referred to as light dependent stage or light reaction stage. Now, just from this word light, which means that during this process, light is very, very important. So now, this is the initial stage of photosynthesis. The chlorophyll molecules in the leaves absorb the light energy, or they trap light energy. Now, what's the function of this light energy in this process? The light energy is used to split water molecules. Remember, in the water molecules, we have hydrogen and oxygen. So the water molecule is split into oxygen gas and hydrogen atoms. So this process is called photolysis. Now, this is from the word photo means light. So the splitting or the use of light to split hydrogen and oxygen is called photolysis or photolysis. Depends on whatever I start to English to pronounce. Okay, we proceed. So now, what's the function of these hydrogen atoms? These hydrogen atoms will be used later on in the next stage, which is called the dark stage. Then what's the effect of oxygen? So while the oxygen gas is released into the atmosphere, when it has been released into the atmosphere, it's the same one that we're going to use as human beings to breathe. Or the plants can use it for respiration. Very good. Now, some of the solar energy that has been trapped by chlorophyll molecules is used in the formation of adenosine triphosphate or ATP. Sometimes in the exam they can ask you what does ATP stand for. So this is the energy that is stored. Now, why is this energy important? It will be used later on in the dark stage. So now, this stage, the light stage, is light dependent and only takes place when sunlight is present. It means that the light stage cannot take place when it is dark. It needs to take place when the sun is shining, or when the sun is shining, that's when it needs to take place. So the other name, or we can call this same stage as light reaction stage.